While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs to defend the ministerial policy statements for the financial year 2024-2025, officials from the National Identification and Registration Authority, NIRA, underlined lack of a home as a key performance challenge for the entity. Teddy Angida, the Manager Planning and Strategy, told Parliament that national ceremonies organized at Kololo have continued to disrupt operations of the entity, hence stifling service delivery.
And it causes a lot of disruptions in service delivery. People come, some people travel from up country, they come and they have nowhere to sleep, they find Kololo closed. So we also suffer inadequate staffing.
She revealed that NIRA lost 33 working days in the 2021-2022 financial year alone, when most government events were shifted to Kololo ceremonial grounds during COVID-19.
Several disruptions, as Kololo is a ceremonial ground and there are very many events that take place there. So we lost a number of working days. We still lose a number of working days, but not as much as then.
Committee members noted that shifting from Kololo was long overdue, wondering why NIRA has not considered it a priority, yet they spend a lot of money renting the facility.
Is it by law that we're supposed to stay in Kololo? Is it by order? Because I know if you are paying rent, you can get somewhere else. If you are getting another department to add to NIRA, yet even you yourself, the environment is not convenient. Are we serving Ugandans?
MPs expressed concerns of the bad experiences which people from upcountry go through when they visit Kololo for ID services and get bounced.
Offices, both in districts and the center, they are renting. I would like to find out, why is it you have ever never budgeted for the construction of your own offices? I thought NIRA is here to stay.
The situation is to be is being proposed to be transferred to NIRA. And you know, in marriage, you can find you have already booked the place, you have already booked where to have the reception, then you come the next day to reach, the place is closed.
It will be closed for public ceremony. Following the day, same. So now, and Honorable Minister, I'm happy that you are here, and the whole team, it is of utmost urgency that we must look into this.
The Minister of State for Internal Affairs, General David Mohozi, assured the committee that relocating NIRA from Kololo is in the offing because it was a temporary home for the onset.
Suitable, big space was Kololo. And I think in the mindset of the late General Ronda, he said, let me seize the opportunity. But Kololo has its issues. I don't want to repeat them. And the problem of shifting, we would shift, certainly we want to shift, whether rented or acquiring property to a home that befits NIRA. But also we have heavy infrastructure that is not easy to move.
In the 2024-2025 financial year budget estimates, NIRA has been allocated 117.236 billion shillings, leaving the entity with a huge funding gap of 333.85 billion shillings needed to fund mass enrollment exercise. NIRA Executive Director Rosemary Kisembo has raised a red flag that they're behind schedule of the Electoral Commission, which needs information from mass enrollment for 2026 election.
Important at this point to highlight that the balance of 366 billion that is needed in 2024-25 has not been provided in the next year's budget.
The ED earlier on, especially now when you can't even afford to lose an hour because we are behind schedule.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.